Okay, and here we are into the Haunt Tour Season 2 playoffs, in fact, as not everything was covered, so I figure I'll pick up the matches that fell by the wayside, as both Hauntcast and Coldcast had better things to do than cover, apparently, NK versus Dre, or BWA, depending on what you want to call them. They're listed as Brothers with Attitude, BWA, on the Haunt Tour standings, but their clan tag is clearly Dre, straight out of Compton. So, apparently, they're extremely hard, and they show that by playing Han, which is probably not the best way to do that. If you're looking to become a gangster, I suggest you don't start with Han. You probably want guns and drugs. But then, again, what do I know about becoming a gangster? I was almost a doctor. That was fantastic. Yeah, even Dre over there is like, why are we getting casted? What the hell? I'm doing it. I'm picking you up here, buddy. They're just too afraid of NK, as of course, certainly NK is the favorite over here on the Legion side. There's no question that No Keyboard or Neon Knights or whatever you want to call them are absolutely favored in this match, and it is already over, so you can see what happens if you'd like, but I don't know. I don't know precisely what happens, so it's always good to try to keep myself in the dark, and then I won't be too biased when it comes to the outcome, but There's no secret, I don't think, that I expect NK to win this match, and that's it, yeah. Spongy over there on the Hellborn side, apparently very, very upset about the fact that they didn't get casted. Apparently, again, Hauntcast and Coldcast, better matches up. Too bad. They did do this in a really strange way, in fact. Group B was 2 weekends ago, February 1st and 2nd, and then, like, they put all the rest of the groups February 8th and 9th, so I don't understand why they did it that way, but oh well. That's the way they chose to have things shake out, and I suppose that's enough talking about that. Gauntlet, Pestilence, Grinnix, and Rhapsody are the bans. Interesting that Rap gets banned out early, especially over Cersei and Ophelia, who we've, you know, Ophir in particular, we've seen banned pretty much all the time. Gauntlet also an interesting ban here from Tankafet, so I don't know if that's them not wanting to play against that hero, or if they're doing some research there. Maybe the Hellborn side loves to run that gauntlet, and they haven't done a lot of that recently, so hey, it doesn't hurt us if we ban out Gauntlet, but then they won't get one of their favorite heroes, and I don't know, possible. I assume that's what the case is we don't really see a first ban use of Gauntlet very often, but other than that, generally pretty sensible bans. And then, of course, you see the Ophelia first pick by Tankafet on the side of NK, as she is considered to be one of the strongest, if not the strongest jungler in the game right now. And there's certainly a lot of evidence to back up that suggestion, as she's extremely powerful, pushes, ganks very well, active early on, one of the few junglers that can, you know, really come into a dual lane with a solo and pretty much get an easy kill at level 5. Parasite might be able to do that if he has the right situation set up for him, but he doesn't provide quite as much lockdown as Ophelia does, so there's that, and of course Parasite doesn't push nearly as hard as Ophelia does. Plus, the teamfight is much better with Oph, and certainly not ridiculous that she's considered first pick material, as Tankafet does use that first pick on Ophelia. And presumably will get put in the hands of Insania, as he's NK's jungle player, and we'll see how well Insania manages to handle that hero. Probably quite well, I suspect, for some reason. I don't know, Insania, pretty good player. To finish off their picks here on NK, they get Bubbles and Pyromancer. So Bubbles has some versatility, of course, mid or suicide. Doesn't typically run that short lane for good reason. I think he doesn't really need it, and it's more beneficial to put a farmer there. Bubbles, obviously not really that type of farm hero. He likes to get level 6, level 7, start roaming a lot, pick up some kills, gank, as that's really where he becomes extremely powerful, and he can use that to snowball and become a really effective CC hero and really ganker. Pyromancer, the last pick hero over on the Hellborns or the Legion side, and I suspect there'll be a support pyro. We don't really see carry pyro run too often anymore, and I think that, you know, pyro is better in a support role. I think she's had a little more success that way. It is a little interesting that they choose to take support pyro so early. It's not exactly a high-tier support that might be extremely valued by another team. So picking that up extremely early is Maybe they know something that other people don't. Maybe they just really like Pyro. Who knows? Meanwhile, on the Hellborn side, Keeper of the Forest, Rush Attack, and Tempest. So lots of pushing, lots of AoE ults, team fights, stuff, that kind of thing. Keeper Tempest, often considered an unstoppable combination. You know, you put those two heroes together and you just win games. I'm a little skeptical of that in this situation just because of the team matchups, but it could still happen. I mean, really giving up those three heroes, who are three of the best heroes in the game, no doubt. Certainly interesting. Honestly, right now, I think Hellborn's draft is substantially superior to Legion's. Bubbles is a nice hero. Ophelia's a very, very good hero. Pyromancer's just okay. And Hellborn have three of the most powerful heroes. I mean, if you're going to put a top 10 hero list together, all three of those heroes should be on it. No question. So, with the Tempest pickup, we are going to see a Suicide Keeper. Of course, his suicide potential nerfed a little bit thanks to the armor debuff he took as a result of the recent balance patch, but should still do well in the suicide lane. We've seen him run in that role a few times since the balance patch, but hasn't really diminished his suicide potential that much, so he should be just fine. Retrotag, I assume we're going to be running that short lane. Could also be a mid. The thing is, if Hag goes up against Bubbles, Suicide Bubbles, presumably, Hag isn't going to have that big an advantage. Of course, Haunt not going to be very successful against an opposing ranged hero. And Bubbles has a little more burst damage than Hag does with the Shell Surf and the Sonar and the Song of the Sea. Sorry, Song of the Scream is Hag's ability. So that's not inconceivable that Bubbles could win that lane. And of course, Hag very rarely babysat. She does like that experience, so honestly, with Zibbe, if Zibbe ends up on that Bubbles in the suicide role, I really wouldn't be surprised if he did take at least an even lane or possibly even a victory against Hag. Of course, he could go the other way as well. No question, Hag can certainly win that lane against Bubbles, so we'll see how they decide to lane things over here on the Hellborn side. Still looking for probably a mid and a support, definitely a support, but it's either going to be a mid or a short laner, depending on where they're going to want to put that Wretched Hag. But the ban's coming out here. Torture, Corrupted Disciple, and Engineer by Tankafet, so addressing those, two strong supports, and then the CD, of course, typically a short laner, and that would put Hag in the mid lane, but that's fine. Soul Reaper, Soul Stealer, and Slither here banned out for the Hellborn side, so clearly addressing their souls, want to keep their souls intact, and so the Soul Hero is taken out on top of Slither. Lots of S's, good. Those are sometimes difficult to pronounce, as those are all really short lane heroes. That's clearly the weakness here for the Legion side. They do need a mid initiator, but they could run Bubbles in that role. They could also run Bubbles Suicide, but they definitely use a short laner because there's no question Bubbles wouldn't be in that role. But of course, still Moon Queen available, Gemini available, Sand Wraith available. So interesting that they'd choose to ban the Soul Stealer and the Slither and the Soul Reaper over heroes like Moon Queen, Gemini, and Sand Wraith, because if you're looking for Legion side to pick up a short lane carry here, they still have probably the three best options on the board. And it is going to be the Gemini. So that's not that surprising. I'm suspecting now these lanes are going to be pretty clear from the Legion side. Ophelia in the jungle, Pyromancer Pebbles in middle, Bubble Suicide, and Gemini solo bot against that Keeper of the Forest, who should do just fine. On the Hellborn side, they picked up that Master of Arms. I'm assuming he's in run of support. He could be run as a mid laner in a dual lane, but it seems a little bit unlikely. Cersei's still available, and actually Cersei Moho could be a pretty powerful lane with that Hag in the short lane, so I really wouldn't mind seeing a Cersei pickup here and then turning Master of Arms into a farmer. If they don't want to do that, they have a few other options. Tundra's on the board, Moraxis is on the board. You could even run a Pharaoh, get crazy with it, devour a prisoner. It is going to be Moon Queen. So this is going to be certainly not surprising there, actually, I didn't mention the possibility of running Hag middle just then. I've talked about it a little bit before, but that's clearly now going to be a Hag middle. Probably Master of Arms babysitting that Moon Queen on bot, or on top, excuse me. Suicide to Keeper of the Forest and Tempest in the jungle. That's going to be a bit of an issue for Zibbe on this Bubbles, of course, as now that they're running a short laner with a babysit, Bubbles is going to be in a lot more trouble, not going to be able to take nearly as much creep farm as he would otherwise be able to. And then, of course, Hag in middle up against Pebble's Pyromancer. If Hag gets caught out by a Stalagmite, she's dead. But that's not going to be the easiest thing in the world. Of course, Stalagmite does have some range on it, but it's not the longest. And if Hag has some pretty decent presence of mind, able to sidestep that Stalagmite's first stun, because Dragonfire definitely has too long a cast time to really catch her out with it. So as long as she's relatively conservative and manages to avoid that Stalagmite stun in the beginning, she should be mostly okay. Probably won't have the greatest farm in the world, as she should get boxed out by Pyromancer pretty effectively, but will be able to pick up a few levels and won't die if she's careful. So Hellborn actually putting together a very strong lineup here. The only concern I have is they really have four heroes there that farm real fast, and that's good in the sense that they'll be able to soak up resources. It's not so good in the sense that both Hag and Moon Queen need some items. Tempest and Keeper are also not... That's not, you know, untrue for them either. They're a little less item dependent than Hag and Moon Queen, in my opinion, but they're both, you know, heroes that need their restoration stones, their shrunken heads, blink daggers, etc. So it's going to take some doing here, I think, to get all the farm that's necessary on all four of these heroes. You know, Hag can survive with the 260, 300 GPM. She'll be alright. Moon Queen sort of needs to get to that 500, 550, 600 range, just because if she wants to carry for real here, and she's going to have to considering there's a Gemini on the other team, that's just what she's going to need to do in order to get the items that she needs to compete with this Gemini. So my only concern for the Hellborn side really is if they're going to be able to take enough farm, and a big part of that is basically going to be, are they going to be able to take the Legion jungle consistently, as Hag is now in some trouble, sitting out here. Here comes Pyromancer, there's the Stalagmites, here's going to be a Dragonfire stun. Bubbles is also here, so wait for the blink, there it is, Shell Surf on top of her, not going to choose to run with it, so Hag is not going to die here. Nice attempted Bloodlust here with Zippe coming in for the initial attacks, but he was a little slow there, I think, and one or two more auto attacks could have been fine, but he was not there right with Pyromancer, and as a result, Hag will live. She is forced to use that health pot right off the bat. And Zippe is now in some trouble with the stun going out, and he's going to Shell Surf away. Now out of mana, half health, forced to eat a tree there, still has two more and a health pot pooled. So solid regen there on Bubbles, but he's now lacking some mana and isn't exactly the highest on health, so Zippy could have some trouble up here in that top lane. Haunt going on with Pyromancer, so interesting that Hag is choosing to go the Haunt build. I suppose that makes some sense with Pebbles in this lane, but honestly, if I were her, I wouldn't even be that opposed to going Blink and Sonar Scream, just because a low-level Blink could actually be the death of her if this lane pushes up toward the Hellborn, towards the Legion Tower. It could still catch her out, and you should like force the Blink out, and then realize that the second one is on too long a cooldown to come out again. And then, of course, she's going to need the Sonar Scream for effective farming later. She's not going to get farm in this lane, so the Haunt build for Harass on Pebbles is certainly not a terrible thing, as apparently Zippe is saying they're dumbasses. He is forced to take his health pot. He's completely out of mana. And he's going to have a hell of a time up here, man. Moon Queen is going to have complete free farm. Pyromancer taking that Haunt as Hag takes a bunch of damage here. Another auto attack there from Pyro, and so actually it is going to be Tankafet playing this Ophelia. Both of them, both Tankafet and Insania, of course, playing that support jungle role, so it's certainly not shocking. Insania has been their more typical jungle player, but clearly in this instance they feel Tanka's Ophelia play is a little bit a step above Insania's, so going to switch up the roles a little bit. Always nice to have that sort of versatility. In the bot lane, Gemini out-leveling Keeper of the Forest, not particularly surprising. He should have pretty serious lane control here. Up top, Pyromancer is invisible, and level 2, so looking to set up on something, but Zippe has nothing. He has 100 health now, eating his final tree, 90 mana, so there's no way that Bubbles can be able to do anything here. He needs to go back and heal. He's still level 1. So very good job here by the Hellborn team, boxing him out. Meanwhile, in mid, Pebble's going to eat the Haunt, as Hag should get some CS here with Pyromancer out of lane. Of course, Pyro's been gone long enough that the Hellborn side should be real careful about where they go and their safety in general. But looks like Insania will come back to this mid lane. Illusion rune, or invisibility rune, has run out. And really nothing doing there with that. Unable to set up a gank. He is coming back in here looking for a pick on the Hag. Gonna sit in the woods here, but Hag's playing super safe, knowing, yeah, we don't know where that Pyromancer is. Dragon Firestone actually gonna hit him. Followed by the Phoenix Wave, so Hag gonna take a bunch of damage here. And I presume with that bottle on pebbles, it will be handed right there, and once this haunt wears off, that'll be chugged. They'll grab the top rune. It is gonna be guarded here by this Tempest, so Tempest... Dragon Firestone on him, actually. And Insania will grab the refreshment. Phoenix Wave on top of that as well. Master of Arms here for a little bit of backup, making sure Tempest doesn't fall. Zibe, still level 1, looking for something up here. At least get some experience. Lots of denies from Moon Queen. And Master of Arms is coming right back saying, yeah, you're not going to sit here without me messing with you a little bit. Pyromancer's up here as well, actually, as it looks like Zibe really needs some help. Pyro's level 3, Master level 2, Moon Queen level 5, and Zibe and his bubble still level 1. Pyromancer's going to get the charge shot. He is going to manage to land the Dragonfire there onto Master of Arms, but won't be enough damage here, just barely. One more auto attack, probably going to finish him off, but of course not in range. Going to chug that bottle once again, looking for a Phoenix Wave. I think he's going to... Yep, not going to happen, though. Now the Moonbeam goes out, and he could be in some trouble here. Moon Queen will have another Moonbeam up now, but meanwhile the Bloodlust goes off onto the bottom, so... Keeper just gets dove. There's a Dust of Revelation, and the Skeleton Gang will trap him in. Ophelia taking a lot of damage here, but obviously not enough, as Keeper will fall. Ophelia in a lot of trouble. Is he going to die to the Keeper minions? Very possible. Tanka's going to need to do some juking here. And I think he'll survive. Up top, meanwhile, Pyromancer's still in a ton of trouble. Dragonfire stun to try to clear the creep wave, as Tanka does fall to the neutral creeps, but Moon Queen picking up the kill onto Pyromancer. So Zibe's level 2 now, that's nice. But MQ level... sorry, I thought it was level 6. I figured he hit level 6 from that kill, but does not. As Haxorin splitting up here, farming with the Ice Dog down here as the Fire Dog goes back to base. And Keeper of the Forest should use this time to take a little bit of control of this lane here, as he did die, of course, but with just the Ice Dog here, he's a little safer. Pyromancer joining Pebbles back in middle, as Pebbles has maintained control of this lane despite Pyro leaving it for really last several minutes. As Invis Tempest with its level 6 is coming in here. Oh god, this is a perfect ult. Just drop it! Dude, they're right next to each other. Oh, he's waiting for Master of Arms, but they're going to see him with this ward of... Nope, there it is, the ward of sight, in fact. Just drop the ult, man. They're right on top of each other. There we go. There's a Sunnoh Scream and the charge. The Fort Lightning Act probably wasn't a great idea. The charge shot's going to be wasted. Pyro will fall, but here comes Ophelia, and Pebbles actually has very little. He's going to get ported back to base. Bagmon leader coming out. And he is going to fall, so... Good gank there from the Hellborn side, using that Tempest ultimate. Interesting that they chose to drop the Fort Lightning and not the Acid Bomb, because I think the Acid Bomb probably would have done a little more damage, especially with the armor reduction. And then the charge shot, for some reason, while the Tempest ultimate was going off, so... I don't know about that play there from Master of Arms. I think, certainly could have gotten closer to a kill on Pebbles and possibly even secured it with a little better play. I mean, if they still had the charge shot up, they probably could have killed Pebbles, because that's what they needed, really, is one more stun. He was relatively low. Zibe, once again, trying to find some CS up top, and Master of Arms is too busy eating a bunch of damage from this creep wave to do anything about it. This is triple stack, so I don't understand why... Boy, that thing follows for a long time. So, I'm not even sure if he got the XP for that, because he might not have been able to be in range. I don't know. Phoenix Wave just barely gonna clip Hag there in the mid, but she'll be fine. I was really looking at it, gold is even, and the experience is in favor of the Hellborn side, so Gray here doing a good job in the early game controlling the team in NK. And NK looking to do something about that with this Hag. Stalagmites are going to miss. Minotaur Stun is available. Batblast comes out on a Minotaur and Ophelia nearly dead, but Pag's going to fall as well. Is the Haunt going to be enough? No, I don't think so, as Ophelia eats a tree here. Meanwhile, the Root comes out, and that will kill Insania. Lots of heroes chasing down Pebbles and Ophelia here. As Hag's going HP. Bubbles is getting dove up here. We'll put the Shell Surf off, out, and he will survive as he ports away. So one for one going down there. Of course, losing Hag for Pyromancer are not a trade that's in favor of the Hellborn side, but at least they picked somebody off. The big problem, of course, is Gemini. He's got 400 GPM. And despite Moon Queen's total free farm up here, pretty much, she has 300, and she has a kill, so... Paxer has a kill too, but there's some issues going on up there, I feel like. There's no reason why Gemini should be that far ahead, as the bot tower gets denied. 60 and 7 CS compared to a 42 and 40 on Moon Queen, so doing a little too much prioritizing the deny, I think. It's impressive to have that many denies, it really is, like, that's a ton of denies. But right there, missing the CS, and clearly... I think doing a little too much to make sure that she denies and not enough to make sure she grabs the CS. She needs the farm more than she needs to keep Zibe's levels down. Zibe is still level 2, and he's having just a terrible game right now. By far the lowest level in game. Pyromancer and Master Farms both level 4. Compared to a couple level 7s on the Hellborn and a level 8 and a level 9 Gemini, so... as Bubbles is just suffering. He is going to get something here now as the tower pushes in. And Moon Queen and Master Arms clearly went interested in doing some damage to this tower. Meanwhile, in mid, Hag goes down again. Frost Breath there. Twin Breath comes up, jumps away, but the Twin Fang spotter out, and that's going to be a death. Tempest coming in here going to help push this top lane, as Moon Queen will take some damage with that finishing off that last creep. And this could very well be a top tower kill. Elementals probably don't have that much time left on them, but here comes another creep wave and Keeper of the Forest. Mid tower falls in the meantime. But it looks like Hellborn's just going to keep pushing this, and why not? As they have very strong team fight. Tempest ult is up, Keeper ult is up, lots of minions here, and Legion has to do something to address this right now. Another big thing, of course, is Zibe is level 2. Word of Sight goes out here, so they know exactly what's going on. Pebbles does not have a portal key quite yet. As he does have a double damage rune, though. So, I don't know, a little interesting there that the Hellborn team decided to back off. They saw 3 coming in, but that they were 4, they have the stronger push, they've got their carry there, and... I mean, the team fight for the Hellborn is way stronger, so if they're like, if you want to take a 4v3 engagement and we have Root, Moon Queen ult, and Tempest ult up, we're going to win that fight. Like, you're not going to win it. Like, Pebbles is going to drop his combo on somebody and maybe kill them, but Bubbles is going to die, Pebbles is going to die, and Pyro is going to die, just because, like, once all those ultimates come out, it's way too much damage to deal with. As the bot secondary tower is getting pushed in here by NK, and the Root's going to come out on 2, in fact. Gemini's going to split up to get out of it, but Ophelia on this tank that's going to be in a ton of trouble. Fort Lightning does not hit. The Haunt is there, slowing him down. There's a Glacial Blast and Moonbeam, so Tank Effect falls. And good training here by the Hellborn side, as Ophelia's minions also get cleaned up, so... That first pick, Ophelia, not doing all that well. 225 GPM on Tank Effect, 02 and 3. He is reasonably effective. With that push, but I think that we haven't really seen the Hellborn teams all of their push yet, and we're starting to right now, as we have a 5-man group up on this bot tower, and this is going to be a dead tower in a matter of seconds. As there it goes, and goodbye. Legion side not choosing to do anything about that. They're just like, yeah, that's gone. You can take it. And certainly you can understand their reasoning for that. And now it looks like we're going to see a bot's secondary tower push. And again, this tower is going to fall fast. And this is what the Hellborn side can do. Very, very easily. So Legion's really going to have to address this. You know, they've got strong farm on Pebbles and Gemini. Not so much in the rest of their team, but this is going to start boosting the Hellborn's GPMs a ton. And I would hope that middle is the next target, because there's really no reason for them to stop this. Legion has clearly shown they're not interested in defending right now, which I can understand, considering that, you know, they don't have really anything to do or anything to defend with right now. Apparently they didn't ask for readies before the Young Paws. I mean, Haxorn on that Gemini is just running away from the push and farming jungle. He's farming other lanes. He's just like, I'm not going to deal with this right now. It's not worth my effort or my time. Keeper of the Forest is still off to the side here, but he will spawn trees in a second, and this is going to be another Cat Tower kill. I don't understand. Where's his trees? Get the trees. As Hellborn is actually going to back off. The whole Legion team is here. Pebbles does have his portal key. As actually Keeper dies to the back, that's Pebbles' portal key right there. Hag dies, I mean. Just a combo. I feel like Hellborn is way too timid for some reason. I mean, they've got these ults. A lot of them. A lot of really powerful AoE teamfight ultimates. And they're choosing not to take teamfights. Like, it's 4-4 hero kill. It was 4-3 hero kill, so they had the hero kill advantage. It's relatively even in golden experience, and right now, the Legion side cannot teamfight. Like, I mean, they have level 6s on Bubbles, finally, and level 6 on Ophelia, so they can do something. Jump here onto Tempest, and he's not going to die thanks to the Astrolabe and the Charge Shot. There's a Glacial Blast, and Kelpfield going to hit nothing. And Master might be in some trouble here. Nope. So now they've blown a Kelpfield, and Ophelia going to come in here, try to clean up some creeps with hers. But maybe they're waiting for level 6 on Master of Arms. I don't know why they would be. This Gemini is going to bring the Ice Dog back to the Fire Dog in bot lane. And the Keeper Dog's just hanging out here. So now, maybe Hellborn is deciding, yes, we are going to push, in fact. I don't know why you'd wait and let your opponents get some levels up, but I guess that's their decision. And now the worry is, of course, that Pebbles can jump in and pick off pretty much anybody who wants to. So basically what they need to understand is, actually there's the Chuck, so that's going to be a free tower. As Legion is once again not going to defend this, which is certainly the right call for them. Like, they cannot teamfight. Especially right now. I mean, Gemini needs a Shrunken Head before he's really ready to do much or anything. He's not close to it either, I don't think. Portal Canal and Bubbles, as he's managed to get that somehow. This bot's top or mid-secondary tower is going to fall in a matter of seconds. Bevel's just throwing out the chucks, trying to delay the push a little bit.
Hellborn destroyed a Legion tower.
And Hellborn backing off for some reason. Go take top secondary tower. Instead, choosing to defend top tower, which is fine. Get the deny. As bot tower falls, and now Gemini gonna get a kill on Master Rums pretty easily here. And Hag's in some trouble as well. Gonna split up, and it's just after the blink, so Hag will survive. But Keeper of the Fort is coming down here looking for something, not going to find it. I mean, really, this feels like way, way too much passive play on the side of the Hellborn here. I don't understand. The Legion has repeatedly showed they're not going to defend towers, even secondary towers. They took two towers and bot without a response. They took a tower in middle, and really two towers in middle, with two heroes responding. And they know that as Hag actually takes the Master's Call there and will survive as a result, so just enough health to eat that Pebbles combo and an auto attack. And that's also going to be an important milestone when they can't eat the Pebbles combo long enough for Master Ult to come out and save them. Because that Master Ult will be mostly off cooldown whenever Pebbles is looking for a gank onto somebody. And that means Pebbles is probably going to take somebody with him in order to get a kill. Probably Bubbles. That Bubbles combo. In mid lane, Hellborn grouped up a bit. Three heroes. Pat gonna jump in onto Matt or Moon Queen. She's gonna take a bunch of damage and fall thanks to all the support coming in. Keltfield's gonna be taking my Wretched Hag. Tempest just sitting here, and now he's gonna fall. As Hag fall in the background as well. Gemini looking for picks. And now Legion side is going to group up and push because they've killed three heroes on the opposing team. Really two of their primary farmers as well. And no surprise, this is going to be turned into a tower push as for some reason now the Legion side and the Hellborn side are going to be tied in towers. And that's definitely not something that should happen. Yeah, I don't know. We haven't seen a Tempest ultimate since, what, like, minute 7? We haven't seen a Keeper root for 10 minutes now. We haven't seen a Moon Queen ultimate ever. Bat Blast went down there, so that was good, but it ended up still being a 3-for-nothing wipe in favor of the Legion side. So, and the pushes haven't been there. If you're going to pick this lineup, and do, like, this is an extremely strong Hellborn team. They got a fantastic lineup here. They work very well together. They're extremely aggressive. Lots of team fight ability. They have some gank potential. I mean, there's no question. There's carries, definitely. There's no question that this is a very strong Hellborn team. I just feel like they're playing it 100% wrong. And okay, not 100%. Like that's a little unfair, maybe. But this is not the way that this is laid. This is supposed to be played. You're not supposed to be this passive. Like, I understand the mentality of let Moon Queen have her free farm, she's just eventually going to carry us to victory, but you've got a Gemini, and she won't do that. Like, she's going to be very valuable, but between the Pebbles initiation doing a bunch of damage and not always killing her, but doing a lot to get her extremely low, and that's going to be the main case of Shrunken Head as she picks up a Mighty Blade, she's not necessarily going to be in every fight. She might get picked off if they jump her. So you cannot put all your eggs in the right-click Moon Queen basket. And that's just, it's not going to work this game. Hag as backup carry is better than anything the Legion has. Not quite as good as Gemini as a primary carry, but you know, certainly better as a number two farmer than anybody else is over here. Master Rom's going to die. Getting picked off by three heroes. Trying to do some warding, and will in fact get dewarded. In middle, Bubbles is hanging out, and he's going to be fine as he just portal keys away. And runs out of there. But anyway, like, I mean, they have the aggression here. They need to force the Legion side to initiate on them and basically say, look, we're going to push you so hard. You don't have that much anti-push. Pyromancer will do some. Shellsurf will do some. Chuck will do some. But we just have so many damn minions, we can keep coming at you. And they're not doing that. Like, honestly, at 20 minutes, they should have had at least pressured base towers a few times by this point. There shouldn't be this top secondary tower. They've had a couple chances to kill it, and they decided to back off. I mean, there's a team fight's going on here. Gemini in the middle of everything. Bubble's going to put a kill field down on all his stores and stuff. As Slice and Dice on that Wretched Hag falls. Tempest Keeper Ultimate actually goes on, locking down Pebbles, and so does the Root. So there's a little bit of stacking going on. The Shell Surf's going to help finish off Keeper of the Forest. So is Tempest dead, and here goes Moon Queens. And then I think also, once again, miscommunication there. Keeper went out on top of Tempest Ultimate. And that shouldn't be like, I mean, you should initiate with the Keeper Root or the Tempest Ultimate. And once one gets canceled, then you use the other one. There's no reason to have two spells locking down heroes at the same time, as Master's just going to die in a second. Pebbles takes the power supply to prevent him from dying. Hag, don't jump in there. And Midrax are going to fall. So 22 minutes in, considering the team compositions, this should be the opposite situation. I don't think that there's a argument to be made that the Legion have a stronger team than the Hellborn do. They have a, they certainly have a good team as well. Like, there's no, obviously no question about that either, as there goes the GV well plays for some reason again. I'm a little disappointed in that, honestly. Like, I think Hellborn played well to some extent, and they drafted amazingly, but they weren't very coordinated, and they didn't know what they needed to do to win this game with this lineup, it felt like. And as a result, they lost. And they lost rather quickly, actually. Like, Haxorin needed to be... He was just saying, you're going to push the towers in, I'm going to free farm, and that's fine. But at some point, he can't do that anymore. So if you're at 14 minutes, if you're pushing a base tower, he can't be farming. And if you keep doing that, he's not going to be able to get any farm. Because he needs to be in middle, or in bottom, or in top, or wherever you're pushing to prevent racks from going down. Because they need to take 5v5 engagements. But... I mean, just Hellborn team never felt like they were really pressuring the Legion side, and I think that's what this came down to. So, good game, well played to both sides, really. And that's doing it for game one, so we'll move on to game two in this three-game series.